Give it up for We Dem Boyz Plus Two, featuring Kyle Losey, Elena Gonzalez, Chris Marmol, Jacob Morris, and Kaylee Allard.
It's hard to yell when the bat rails in your mouth. Come on. Bring them out, bring them out. Hey. Bring them out, bring them out. Yeah. Bring them out, bring them out.
This life works in funny ways, devious concepts, I guess, manifesting inside the labyrinth of our very own existence. Tell me why the words take refuge in the caverns of my lungs only when it matters, only when I want the truth to echo loudly. And tell me why it's so much easier to express myself through 4 inches of light-emitting diodes, waiting for a response of assurance to echo on back, hoping just maybe it will bring back an age of easiness. A balanced era of sincerity and simplicity, and tell me why the blame is always placed on autocorrect. Because we sure as hell autocorrect this life before turning back isn't so easy as a tap on the back space. And care to explain why we continually place our thoughts and candids in a cloud, ignoring the simple fact that every cloud eventually fades? Let's bring it back to toss notes and shots in the dark, back to drive-ins and fast times. Can we just try? Can we work on it? Because I'm growing tired of choking on the truth and falling back on feelings in the form of a text.
We have a 9.0, an 8.7, an 8.7, an 8.3, a 9, and an 8.2.
If I should have a son, I will open as many doors for him as he should be opening for his significant others. Whether he wants to pick up a football or tap shoes, I will be beside him guiding his hands in whatever direction his heartstrings pull him, because the football field and the dance studio are the same distance from our house. And if he brings home a beautiful woman or a beautiful man, I will make sure he treats either with no less respect than he would a military general, because love is war, and he needs to learn to lower his gun to his peers who mock him for the way he is magnetized towards a fridge that consists of papers displayed reading, "Your boy is different." I will say, "Son, the Bible may have said Adam and Eve, not Adam and Steve, but that doesn't mean you can't think Steve is totally gorgeous." My son will ask me to buy him a baseball mitt so he can fit in like a glove with the other boys who would beat him with a bat if they could. "Three strikes, you're out," they'd yell, because God forbid you dared to love who you love. And I'd say, "Son, where's the rule book to love anyway? Is it etched in stone that you are not allowed to embrace who you want? Because if I find that stone, I will throw it into a river and pray it stays submerged forever, because love should be swimming, head above water, lungs expanding with the rush of acceptance, because sometimes what society thinks is too wrong can make a right. I now pronounce you man and man, uttered just as beautifully as man and wife, so your wedding will be announced as M and M, and when they ask how I'm so accepting of my son's sexuality, I will reply with the words of M and M. Have you ever loved someone so much you give an arm for? Not the expression, no, literally give an arm for? And I will lend you my arm to hold as we walk down the aisle. I will lend you my arm to push away the negative. I will lend you my arm to grasp the positive. In sickness and in health, for better or for worse, until death do us part, son, I am damn proud of you."
We have a 9.5, a 9.2, an 8.7, an 8.9, a 9.7, and a 9.9.
When I walked into that room, I could see the excitement in your bloodshot eyes. I knew the day we saw each other again, things would be better than before. The smile on your face was something I've missed. I missed that obnoxious laugh of yours, one that will now ring through my head for the next 3 months. I was told I can give you a hug, and for some odd reason, I had knots in my stomach. Maybe it was because I knew I wouldn't be able to handle the pain of letting go again. You put your metal shackled hands over my pounding head, and there it was, the love of a father and son that was reconnected, a love I wanted to feel for so long. You said, "I love you, Chris, stay out of trouble," and I was lost for words. "I love you too." I couldn't promise you I would stay out of trouble, though. All I could promise was that I would try. try to make you proud of me. They took you away, and I watched as you walked away in that fluorescent orange jumpsuit. My heart sank, broke into a million pieces, like a glass window that a rock was being thrown through. Mom grabbed me as I leaned towards the wall, exploding into tears, telling me it'll be all right and you'll be home soon. Don't make me go through this again. I'm too broken for you to leave me again here alone. Come home, Daddy, and please stay this time. I love you.
We have a 9.4, an 8.9, a 9, an 8.9, a 9.1, and a 9. Will all the poets please come up on the stage for a final bow? This concludes our second round of the slam. The scores from both rounds will be combined.